it's about the size of a football field. Total cubic volume of the reef is about 14,000 cubic meters. The largest geotextile bag in that reef is about the width and height of a bus, but about 70 meters in length.
It's a multi-purpose reef, is what we call it at ASR. And the purposes that we use it for are for coastal erosion, protection for coastal erosion to stop wave energy. We use it to enhance ecology and biology on the reef. And we also use it for a recreational amenity, which could be diving, surfing, or fishing. And the reefs, the material that the reefs are made out of are geotextile fiber.
The biggest impact with respect to ecology for a multi-purpose reef is the fact that the reef itself creates marine habitat. So it provides a place for plant and animal life to live and thrive. There's a home for marine habitat to colonize, and it's already doing a really good job of that. There's cuttlefish eggs that are attached to the reef. There's spider crabs and seahorses and a variety of different plant and animal life that are already calling the reef home. And if there wasn't any development on the coastlines of the world, Mother Nature would have our coasts ebb and flow, and you wouldn't really feel the impact. The reality is that because we've developed majority of our coastlines, we've essentially drawn a line in the sand. If we don't defend those coast resources for communities, for people who live there, for stakeholders, tax bases and things, we're talking about millions and millions and millions of dollars. And I don't think that it's realistic to assume that stakeholders who actually have a vested interest in those assets are going to allow them just to fall into the sea. So they're going to do something to protect them.
I think it will definitely benefit the South Coast for surfing, for recreation, for the whole regeneration of the area. As you say, in some circles, it's believed that some of the artificial reefs haven't worked. It's true, that some where they've been placed, maybe not the right place to put them. Maybe the construction's been wrong. I know there have been problems. They've usually been rectified, and they do work. People need to be educated on how it works first and foremost, I think, and then we can open it up to, it's great for eco and all sort of diving and sorts of other sports. You speak to anyone that's not a surfer and you mention swell, they don't know what it is. You mention low pressure systems, how waves work, anything to do with how we predict waves, and they're flummoxed totally. And putting an artificial reef in, I think just the word artificial makes them think artificial wave is a wave machine. We go down in the morning, press a button, on it comes, and that has definitely been the case here. How you educate people from the start about that is a very difficult thing.
It's wonderful what a smile can hide if the teeth shine bright and it's nice and wide.